So let's continue our lesson or our series about skeleton. And I have mentioned that if you want to make a small website or if you want to make a landing page, you don't need to learn something high level like materialize or foundation. But you want a micro framework which has the basic tools that you want day by day, such as a grid system or such as typography or such as the buttons. Or the formula. All these tools or all these styles are found and you can find it easily in Skeleton or any framework such or any micro framework. So let's see what this framework can provide us. It's the first advantage for this Skeleton framework, which is responsive, or it's built like Bootstrap. It's built for the you can build your website for mobile first, and it's as you can see, it's around, it's lightweight, and this is a grid system. It has a 12 column fluid grid made based on Flexbox, and it has maximum size of 960 pixels, and this is the same size for grid system or the basic grid system. For I think also for Twitter Bootstrap, and as you can see, it has 1 to 11. If you have two column here, so the remaining is 10. So how you can define the grid system? It can easily by the container to wrap element like this. In the so it's now 960, and you can define a row. Then you can define one column here. And 11 column like columns like this, so one column or 11 columns, so two columns is in 10 columns. So this is a grid system, and the typography, this framework is based on Railway from Google Fonts, and it says that the line height is 24, I think, and the basic font size around 15. All these things are set by default, and this is the Railway font. It's a very very nice font. And what about the buttons? Buttons, it can be defined easily by button or button primary. If you want to button, so you will get a basic button like this, and the button primary will be like this. This is the button, and the form, as you can see, this is nice form, and it has been defined by row. And if you want to be this element to be fully wrapped in the container, you can define this U full width, and like this U full width in the text area U full width, and in the select like this, it has be U full width to be wrapped completely in the six columns. What we have here also, we have the list. And we have the code. If you want to wrap code like this, you can say pre tag and the code, and put your code inside this, so it will be display the code nicely. And it has the tables, and it has this media query. So for the phone or the mobile, it has minimum or I think maximum width for 400 pixel, and everything above this will be a tablet. Everything will be a tablet. Everything more than 750 will be a tablet, and this will be everything between these values will be a desktop, and it will be high large desktop. And finally, we have this what I have mentioned earlier, U full width to be 100, maximum width U max full width, and we have ball right, ball left, and clear foot U clear. So this is athletic classes, and as you can see, we will make in this. Let's see what we have, and so before we start to make our project, I must say that this framework has some drawbacks. The first drawback, it's update in I think the around 2 years ago it have been updated, and if you want something and also if you want to ask something, so the community for this framework isn't much large as others. So let's start by using Sublime Text, and I have started this file, and after that I will make this new template, and after that I will say that we have this div is a class of container, but we haven't yet added any link, so we will link our CSS. We have the we can say framework, or we have the skeleton classes. So let's save. Alright, so if you go here, we have some skeleton which is here, and we have the normalize. We will use both. We will use it to reset. This normalize will be used to reset, and this is a framework, and this is our own styles. So let's start by adding all these. So we have the framework which is skeleton, and after that we have the reset which is normalize, and finally we have our own styles, which is styles.css. If you want to override the basic styles, or you want to customize your own styles, you must add these styles. In all cases you want to add your own styles, but let's get started by, as you can see here, we have this template. It's not loaded perfectly, but we have here is this header, or this main area, and this is section number one, and we have here a phone. So let's get started by making a row. So we have the container, and we have the div class of row, and also I will say it Android area. And after that we have two classes, which is this one, which is bar graph and the button, and we have this iPhone. So we have bar graph, button, and iPhone. Firstly we have a row which is all this, and we have this in around 7 maybe 6 column, I think 6 columns. So let's start by making a div class, and class of maybe 7 columns. Let's say it will be say 6 for now, and we have another 6 columns, so it will be 12. So we have here our graph, and I will copy some text and paste it here. Feel free to use your own Lorem Ipsum text. And after that I have an anchor tag. This anchor tag will be pointed to nothing, and it has the class of a primary button like this, and maybe click here. After that we have in this 6th column we have an image source to be images, and iPhone I think dot png, and class will be maybe mobile image like this. Let's see what we have here. So in our image we have this iPhone, and we can copy because it has been here. Later we will see how it's work, but I think now we can add a comment here. Let's add a comment and it will be here in first section. So we have four sections, and after that I will copy this comment, and after the container here I will paste it here, second section, another time and another time. So we have this to be third section, and we have it to be fourth section. And after that I will start a new row, which is a new section, and maybe let's see what we have here. So we have, it will be, let's say, statistics, or maybe info. So we will say info. So info area, we have three columns. So we will say that we have div class of four columns, and we have another four columns. So inside this we have three paragraphs. So what we have here, and I will say we have a class div class of a column. This will be make every item a new line. So we can say of inside this we have paragraph, and inside this we will say that we have this percent, and let's copy it another time, another column, and you have info of purchase increase. And we have this final thing. And after that, let's say we have four. So I will copy this and paste it here and paste it here. So what we have here, we have 9%, and we have this, and we have this increased text. So let's start another time. I will leave it at this. So let's go for the third section. We have here something very simple. We have a paragraph, and you have a paragraph, but it's around, I think it's around 8 column maybe, or 10 column. So how we can achieve this? It's a simple div, or maybe div, and class of row, and we have here this row, and we have this row, and we have this. So we can say that and class of you full width. And another time, then we have anchor tag and point to nothing. Class will be primary button, and we have this to be view the docs, and I think we are now done. So let's come for the first section. So we have also a div class of row, and we have here paragraphs, two paragraphs. So it's not a paragraph because, but it's a head 3, so I think we must change it to be head 3. And this will be the paragraph, and let's copy it. And just it here. And then we have an arrow, another row. And we have another row. And this time we have the two divs. Class of 6 columns. And we have an image source to be images, and placeholder.png, and I think a class will be tiny image. Let's copy this and paste it here, and you can see our page. So I will refresh in the web browser. You must open this index.html in the web browser. Alright, so this is a web page. And as you can see, it's not as the image that we have seen. So how we can make it looks like the image that we have seen? So how we can make this image to look like this one? So let's start from here. So I will start to open our own and I will try to open it in here. We won't use all this. So I will delete and start from the first section, which is here Android area. So I will say Android area, and I think we can say that it will be an H1 and explore our new features in the website, maybe, or in the form. So we have this, and let's refresh again, and I think maybe H2 or H3 maybe, and we will increase the font now. We say it has now Android area and H3, and let's refresh. After that, we have font color EEE and font size 2M. Let's try, and I think 3M maybe, and E4. Let's try this color. And background, let's firstly make background which is here. So I will say that this first class will have background. It's white, but I want to make it F9. And after that, it's color not safe. There is no font color, so save and refresh again. And I think I will go for here for this and say it primary button and button. And after that, I will say we have here this. And I will say it will be position to be relative. And after that, we have an image which is here. Let's say it will be display to be a block. And we have a width of 50%, and we have position of absolute. And let's see what we have here, and let's refresh again. And as you can see, it's now much better, but we want it to be, let's say it would say maybe 25, and I think it's correct. But let's now so it's here. If you see here, let's refresh again.